Hi, my name is Hugo, and this is our submission to the Minecraft Open-Endedness Challenge. Open-Endedness is one of the great unsolved scientific challenges, and creating systems that behave in an open-ended way will pave the way towards better artificial intelligence and artificial life. Our solution is inspired by morphogenesis, the growth process that changes a simple cell into complex organisms. We use a model based on CIIRC automata that can learn to grow patterns from simple seeds. Many evolution simulations use a fixed set of components that doesn't change. With neural cellular automata, components are grown cell by cell autonomously, allowing for more flexibility. We train these neural cellular automata to grow multiple patterns from different types of seeds. In this example, we use one seed for the head and one seed for the body. We call these seeds genomes because they encode the information about the patterns into a compact representation. By manipulating and replacing parts of these genomes, we can create all sorts of hybrids. We turn this idea into a game within Minecraft, where the user has to construct and choose the seeds to create new interesting patterns. A Minecraft player can engineer the seed and modify the pattern in real time to partly inhibit or excite its growth. Similarly to games like Big Breeder, the open-endedness comes from users interacting and choosing which patterns to evolve from or mutate. The seeds can be evolved, merged, or mutated to create novel shapes as long as you wish. Results are sometimes surprising, with patterns growing in unexpected ways. An interesting advantage of our approach is that the results depend both on the player decisions and the natural growing rules of the system. Once a player understands the role of each part of the seed, he can copy and reuse them like modules. We observed evolution-like properties, like the effects of crossovers and mutations on the resulting phenotypes. We extend the game to three dimensions by using 3D cellular automata trained with the same principles on 3D shapes. The Minecraft environment allows the user to shape the seed in an intuitive way and to observe the results in space. By modifying the seed in 3D, we can get crazy-looking shapes by using parts of the initial patterns. In this example, we get an animal with something that looks like the body of a duck and the head of a rabbit. Here are a few more of the strangest creatures we are able to get by mutating and selecting seeds within Minecraft. With many more starting seeds and their rearrangements, we can only wonder how many new interesting animals, objects, and structures could be created with our simulation.